This is the second video in a series I've been working on for different skills used by defensemen when they're playing their strong side in the offensive zone, just some different options across the blue line. We'll run through a few different ones here. By no means is this all of them. I had about another 6 clips I had added in here, but it just gets too long with everything in here. So just focused on some of the main ones that I've picked up and seen that are being used quite a bit. So the first one we're going to look at here on this draw is just a D-to-D spread blue line, it's called. So as we let it run here, puck goes up to a lefty on the left side. So guy playing his strong side, and he's got his partner over here. And the partner should be falling back this way to create space between that top winger and himself for a hard pass across, and he's actually sliding backwards and shooting in motion. So he's sliding, calls it, no stick handles, eyes up, gets a shot through. That's very basic, something, you know, definitely to work on. This one here, again, Klingberg picks up the puck, and this is kind of where the two different theories collide, dragging across the blue line or turning and sprinting with it and then getting set up to shoot later. So back years ago when I played and what we were taught, it was generally drag the puck. But what you find is players that drag the puck, if they're standing where Klingberg is here, if they're standing at a standstill and they get that pass, dragging isn't a very efficient it's not the most efficient way to get to the middle and get around this top forechecker. This top forechecker is coming out to take away the puck. So being able to pull and get into an area for a shot around that forechecker, or pull that forechecker's lane this way and throw the puck back to the half wall, is pretty important. So just sprinting across the blue line more than dragging it. When I see, you know, sometimes when I'm at the rink and I'll see a young coach working on passing up to their defenseman, and they're standing looking at the boards, you know, this defenseman standing looking at the boards right next to them, and then they start doing C cuts backwards, that's not a very efficient movement at all. Defenseman up here should be in motion, should never be standing still, and if you are standing still, you want to pick that puck up and start moving in one motion rather than stopping it and then moving it. Something really good to work on with young players is think of it as one motion, picking up and dragging. Anyway, I'll let it play here. So Klingberg is going heels to the middle crossovers, and then he just pushes his top hand out away from his body for that pass back to the half wall. So effective, ends up in a goal. Pretty much the same play here. Chicago defenseman crossovers backwards and surrounds the puck. I don't know if anybody uses the term surround the puck, but it's fairly common. The puck is here, and the player has surrounded it. So he started going backwards and he just pulled his body kind of right around the puck and surrounded it for a shot. Same play here as Klingberg, just fakes a slapper and goes back to the half wall. These ones are pure drags. It's players spinning their heels to the middle of the ice and crossing over or C-cut, skating backwards. So Doughty here, you see he turns his heels to the middle right there, fake shot, crossover, C-cut, and keeps dragging that puck. So it's effective, it works. It's just making sure you have time and space to get off the boards, skating backwards. And kind of the evolution of it here is, so Carlson, right-handed shot, playing the right side, picks up that puck, and if you notice his skate that's closest to the middle of the ice, the toe is pointed towards the middle of the ice. So rather than spinning and dragging with your skates going backwards, he's opened his hips, and he's pushing to the middle. So his skates are going across the ice towards his partner rather than dragging. And here he just goes into a heel to heel, surrounds that puck, and pass back to the half wall. Missed pass, but the tactic or the skill along the blue line was correct. So another thing generally work on with young players is a quick deceptive little backhand pass in this. So as you can see here, the puck comes up, Phillips grabs it, he's facing the net right now, does a crossover and turns that foot that's closest to the middle of the ice turns that into the middle. And that's where, you know, you call it a walk or a sprint or whatever. So dragging is generally when you turn your heels and you're dragging the puck behind you. I used to call it a walk, but when you say walk, young players generally like to walk across the blue line. But if you call it a sprint, and in practices you make sure that it's a sprint, it'll be a habit they have going forward rather than just a slow, non-explosive walk off the blue line there. So he's going across here, and again, any blue line, any guy in the blue line is just going to take a read on what this forechecker is doing. And he comes across and just chips that puck on the backhand really quickly back. Again, same thing, kind of comes across and just chips it into an area. Being able to have that deceptive little backhand chip, I find really important. You can work on that in practice in numerous drills. And here's kind of the evolution of it. What I see is guys sprinting across the blue line. I mean, Larson didn't start from over at the blue line here. He kind of came in a little bit late, but found that puck, and he's going across the blue line. And this is the thing I keep seeing and harping on. Skates are going laterally across the ice, and his chest is pointing at the net. So being able to separate upper from lower body is crucial for young players. And you can see his stick position. He's dropped that stick down. He's got the puck behind his heels. So rather than surrounding the puck like those other ones that we've seen, if he was to surround the puck right here, he'd have to take his skates and spin his heels both around this way, and then he'd be in a drag. But if you think about this, the time it takes him from this position to spin his heels around and surround that puck and shoot it versus just getting that puck off is... Again, neither of them are right or wrong, but being able to do both of them, I think, being having young defensemen to be able to shoot like that or even pass, find lanes like that is pretty important. So something we should probably work on. And then this clip I show quite a bit. It's Duncan Keith. There's just so many good things that happen in this clip. Duncan Keith is right down here, and you can see where he is in regards to the top of the circles. He's got his feet moving. He's in motion, and... he just picks up that puck off of a pass. He's in motion, skating backwards, so it's a drag in motion, and that's what a drag should look like rather than standing up at the blue line with feet stationary. So when you're working on it with young players, make sure that they, you know, if you want to start them from up here and take one shot, you know, start them, have them standing up at the blue line, picking up a puck, walking it across the middle, but after they shoot the puck, have them dip down like Keith did here and be skating backwards and pick up that puck in motion and start a drag, just so they're practicing the two different skills rather than just one. So pretty high-end move, but strong side option. And last clip here is young Swede Dahlin. Strong side, just comes in. Ability to pull that puck back too and manipulate it and be deceptive is pretty important. This is something you can work on. You can have a net right there where the player has to come down and fish a puck out of a net and then take a stride or two backwards, pull that puck around the net. You know, so if you just had a net sitting up here in that area with some pucks inside of it, and that player came down and grabbed a puck out of there and just did that exact same move what Dahlin just did there, a way to work on it. So just a few options off the strong side. Hope this helps. Thanks for all the views on the winger breakout. I'm over 4,000 now, which is kind of cool. I didn't know if these things were going to take off or not, so hopefully find some value in this. Thanks.